Hello everybody. Today I want to share with you several different ways to make your home feel inviting and to show that you love on your home as a homemaker. So these are just some areas that I have compiled and put together for you in a list. And if you have more, I'd love to hear them in the comments below. And then I have a few bonus areas and ways to make your home feel inviting at the end as well. So the first way to make your home feel inviting is to have a fresh smell when someone enters your home, whether that be with a diffuser, some candles, of baking, that always just hits you right away when you walk into someone's house and it just smells good. You don't want it to smell, if you have pets, like wet dog, or if you had fish or something the night before, you want a nice fresh smell in your home. For the entry area, when you step on someone's stoop or their deck or their front sidewalk, you want it to be nice and clean and welcoming. So having a swept off stoop and a welcome mat is just a wonderful way to make someone feel that they can wipe their feet and come on in your door. Also, in that entry area would be to have a place to hang your coat and put your shoes. It's hard to walk into someone's house and feel like you have to hold your coat and not sure if you can sit down to take your shoes off or if you should leave them on or whatnot. So having just a small little space or a chair to throw your coat over and sit down and take your shoes off is just a great way to make people feel very welcome in your home. Another area and way to make your house feel welcome and inviting is having open spaces to sit. I don't know if you've walked into a house before and they have books on their couch or something all over their kitchen, chairs, but there's just nowhere to sit and you feel like you literally have to stand the whole time until they realize, oh, you're standing, let me clear that off for you. So having a place to sit that is clear and cleaned off makes someone feel so welcome. That also means clear surfaces and counters. So yes, you can have knickknacks and such on your table or a shelf, but having it free of all that extra clutter just makes the eye and the person feel, yes, this is a house I would love to be in and visit with a person. And yes, we're there to see people for the people, not their homes. But I also just think the atmosphere of the home can set the tone for an inviting house. And so with that too, the ambiance of the home, the lighting. I went into a house recently, all the shades were drawn. This was 3 p.m. and it was a beautiful sunny day. All the shades were drawn, there were no lights on. They had stuff all over their furniture. I almost was ready to just walk out and leave because I just felt overwhelmed and that the person really didn't want someone to be there. And so making sure, you know, if it's sunny and you open your blinds, it just draws that natural light in. It makes people feel brighter and cheerier. If you don't want the blinds open, having just different lamps around or an overhead light on, something just to make it feel that you are welcome in their home. To like the bathroom area, one area I would recommend is having clean hand towels and clean kitchen towels. If someone has to use your restroom, you don't want mud streaked all over your hand towels. You know, you want something nice for them to use. Make sure that toilet paper is refilled. You know, just those little simple things to make someone feel that they can use your restroom. And so I'm going to add some bonus parts here that kind of relates to some of those smaller things, but that just adds so much life to your home and makes it inviting. So would be offering drinks or food. So if you have that smell when you enter your house, have that fresh smell, baked cookies. Do have cookies if you have someone coming who you know is coming. If it's unplanned, it's a little bit harder, but sometimes in the summer months, I'll have like lemonade or tea in the fridge, or even just offering a glass of water with something that you had made, like a slice of bread with jam, like banana bread, or keep cookies in your freezer so you can pull those out and be like, here, have a cookie if you would like to, just to make someone feel that they are there to stay and visit with you. You can also have flowers, especially in the summer months, fresh potted flowers on the stoop, flowers on your porch, whatever that may look like for you. In the winter months, I love having faux greens, faux flowers all around my house, buying a bouquet of flowers. Just that real life makes me feel like I am welcome in a home. And then to also have like comfy throw pillows and a comfy blanket throw or afghan on your couch. It's really hard to sit on a couch and you have a pillow there that is just hard as a rock. You want something semi-comfy. It doesn't have to be expensive, but something that is decent if someone wants to lean against, to relax on, and if it's chilly in your home in the winter or something like that, have just a nice throw over the couch or in a blanket basket that makes someone feel that they can grab it and use it if they want. And again, kind of to the bathroom, make sure your stools are wiped down just a little bit at least, in your countertops. You don't want makeup smeared all over the countertops, and you don't want streaks running down the sides of the toilet. To me, that is just very off-putting and makes it hard for me to want to even use someone's bathroom. So those are, I think I had 7 and then some bonus. So I think I had about 10 or so total tips on to make your home inviting as a homemaker. And now there are plenty more, I'm sure, and some of these you may not agree with, but these are what I feel make my home feel inviting and what I work on as well. So I hope these tips motivated you to maybe do some of them today and go fluff up your pillows, get a new afghan if you need. It doesn't have to be expensive, it could be thrifted. Wipe down your counters, you know, make sure there's not a lot of clutter, because who knows the next time someone's gonna pop by and you want to make them feel welcome. So hope you're having a blessed and wonderful day, and I'll talk with you in my next video.